Hello friends, in this presentation we are going to learn about a writing skill, information transfer. Information is of two types, verbal and non-verbal. Verbal information is always presented in the form of paragraph, we all know, and non-verbal information has got different types. We are going to learn about them in this presentation. You can see a paragraph over here. This paragraph is about do's and don'ts for the visitors to a public garden. Take your time, pause the video and read the paragraph thoroughly. When the information is presented in the form of paragraph, as it is presented here, we call it as verbal information. However, non-verbal form of information can be presented through pie chart, graph, web diagram, tree diagram, table, etc. Let us have an example of a tree diagram. Here is a paragraph. We are supposed to read this paragraph. We will be finding out what the paragraph is about and then convert the same information in a tree diagram. You can pause the video and read the paragraph carefully. For the sake of presentation, I'll brief you that this paragraph is about methods of communication. As the paragraph narrates three methods of communication, we have divided these methods, showing three arrows, verbal, non-verbal, and audio and visual. Before dividing these methods, don't forget to add a title to your diagram. Here we have given the title, Methods of Communication. Now let's write more about each and every method. From the paragraph we come to know that verbal mode is of two types, oral as well as written. In oral method we have face-to-face communication with use of mechanical devices. And in written mode of communication we have reports, letters, circulars, etc. And it provides a record of what has been communicated. The second method of communication according to the paragraph is non-verbal method. It is without language, using facial expressions, gestures, eye movement, postures, etc. And the third method mentioned in the paragraph is audio and visual. Films, computer, television, internet, projectors, video conferences, etc. are the different modes of audio and visual methods of communication. In this way, tree diagram can be prepared when there is classification or types of certain thing is expressed. Tree diagrams are also useful for preparing family trees. Now, in this slide, let us try to understand what a flowchart is. Flowchart is useful to show a sequence of any movement of action or sequence of a process or step-by-step narration, maybe of a process or a recipe. You can pause the video and read the paragraph thoroughly. In this paragraph, we come to know about the process of desalination, and this process we have tried to convert in the form of a flow chart. Let's see the steps. The first step is the pre-treatment plant. Here the byproduct is the solid disposal. Then from this treatment plant the process goes on and the saline water is cleared of solids and goes to desalting plant. Here the byproduct is salt. From desalting plant, the further process is desalinated clear water that we get as a product, and the last step is the post-treatment plant from where it gets supplied to different channels. When you read the paragraph carefully, you will understand how I have divided these steps and shown using a same direction. When we prepare a flowchart, don't forget that it has to flow within a single direction. In this way, we have tried to cover the basic idea of information transfer when we will be having our classrooms again and we will be having our face-to-face sessions. We will try to give you all details required for this information transfer. Thank you.